The Wisconsin legislature will have a tough job ahead of it, but is it a full-time job?
Some political insiders say a part-time legislature would make for better results. 12 News' Ken Wainscott investigates.
Well, for years, supporters of the idea have argued that a part-time legislature would save time and taxpayer money. The way it would work for lawmakers, they say, is simple. Get in, get the job done, and go home.
When they take their oath and take their seats in January, the state legislature will be back on the job full-time. And the head of the Wisconsin Taxpayers Alliance says that's a problem.
It's not only a professional career legislature, it's a highly partisan, gridlocked legislature.
Todd Berry believes a full-time legislature is an inefficient one, and that the fear of losing that job can leave lawmakers reluctant to make tough decisions.
When you have a career involved, you're not going to make hard decisions and hard choices and be particularly courageous because you want to be reelected, because there's a salary attached to that and some really good state benefits.
It's bad business. It's a bad way for government to work.
Sheldon Wasserman believes Wisconsin's legislature is actually full-time in name only.
Is this right now a part-time job?
Yes.
Dr. Wasserman says he knows because he's done it, having served 14 years in the state assembly, while at the same time maintaining a full-time medical practice in Milwaukee.
Government runs better, you think, with a part-time legislature?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I think you save time, you save money, and you create an efficient legislature with people with outside jobs.
And some current lawmakers agree that there may be some merit to the idea of having an outside job while also serving inside the Capitol.
I think my experience being in business outside of the building as well as being a legislator keeps me more connected and more balanced about how I look at solving problems. So I'm very interested in the way that we could structure a legislature that would be more oriented towards part-time people.
The National Conference of State Legislatures lists 10 states with full-time lawmakers. Wisconsin is the smallest of the 10 in population, but it's eighth in compensation. Legislators here are paid close to $50,000 a year, plus most qualify for an $88 per diem. Two bigger states, New Jersey and Florida, pay their full-time lawmakers less. And there are also 10 other states larger than Wisconsin that spend less by having part-time legislatures.
The issue here is not saving money, it's the decisions they're making with our money.
But the issue isn't quite so clear-cut. One former lawmaker points out that there can be serious drawbacks to a part-time legislature.
My concern is about having a legislature that represents the people.
UWM Government Affairs Professor Mordecai Lee is a former state senator who says a part-time legislature would attract only those who have the time to spare.
But what about people who come from blue-collar categories or come from professions where you can't take off for 3 months? They can't serve in the legislature.
But most agree that the lawmakers aren't likely to vote themselves out of a full-time job.
Can this happen?
No. I don't mean to say it's so straightforward. No.
The honest answer would be probably no.
Leaving Wisconsin with the same full-time system it's had for decades.
This is not a good system that we've got right now, but it's, I think, the best of the worst.
And Todd Berry of the Taxpayers Alliance also believes that Wisconsin should not only have part-time lawmakers, there should be more of them, a lot more, maybe three times as many, and he explains why he thinks that makes good sense in our web extra at WISN.com.
Now, Sheldon Wasserman already said that this is a part-time job. What, it's already that way. What does he mean by that?
Well, there are actually only a few dozen official floor session days in a year. He says there's a lot of time wasted with unnecessary political grandstanding after a vote's been decided, that the work that's actually done there could be done in a lot less time and for a lot less of the taxpayers' money.
All right, Kent. Thank you.